Take back the city for yourself tonight. I'll take back the city for me. Take back the city for yourself tonight. Whoa, whoa. God knows you put your life into its hands, and it's both cradled you and crushed. But now it's time to make your own demands. Whoa, whoa.
Well, I mean, I think this record just, I just wanted to put it into context, I guess. Every other record has been quite insular. It's about my problems, my relationship problems, I guess. Mm-hmm. This time around, the relationship in the record is fully functional, fully functioning, should I say. Yeah. And so I then was free to talk about what was happening around me as well as what's happening inside me. A lot more. So I guess the record stretches out, hence the title. Yeah. It's pretty far-reaching, I guess. I'm a calamity magnet in many ways. Just meeting this person just kind of grounded me and just made me much calmer and much less inclined to go mental. We started in Galway in a little house by the water's edge, the edge of a lake. So we just sort of re-acclimatized. We got together all the songs, all the best songs that I'd written over the Eyes Open tour, and we started to rehearse them as a band. And then, we'd spend the days rehearsing and then the evenings cooking dinner. All of us can cook very well and cook many dishes, so yeah. For six guys together, you'd think it would be a lot more microwaved, yeah, food and shit, sort of takeout food, you know, but there wasn't a takeout near us, so
you had to cook for yourself.
Living a kind of, Seamus Heaney called it a kind of den life, in his Nobel lecture speech, which is when he won the Nobel Prize in 1995. Well, that happens, there's like a really wonderful bit of writing about Northern Ireland and his early life in Northern Ireland, you know, during the Blitz and during life after that. He calls it this kind of den life, where they're living in kind of dark rooms and all on top of each other, and it was kind of like that, you know. It was more luxurious, I'm sure, than we had. Probably an inside, we had an inside toilet, he probably had an outside toilet, okay, we had, yeah, electricity, they probably didn't, but yeah. It was that kind of getting back to just the core of what we essentially do, yeah, which is we make music together, forget about everything that's happened before, because it doesn't mean anything really when it comes down to it. What we're trying to do is achieve something new, achieve something else to what has happened before. You can't carry in any preconceptions or try and recover or emulate something that you've done in the past, because it's meaningless, really. If you keep repeating yourself, then you're not making art anymore. You're just wasting people's time. Then we went to Grouse Lodge, which is a studio in right in the middle of Ireland, and it was after 7 weeks there, in the peace and quiet and idyllic landscapes and animals trotting around. See some animals on the walls here, I'm not 100% sure about that, but then we went to Berlin after 7 weeks there. Well, it was like 13 weeks in total in Ireland, so that's, it's kind of enough peace and quiet, yeah, you know. Then it was time to get into this big city, and a place we hadn't spent too much time. We'd played like four gigs in Berlin before, okay, so we didn't know the place very well. So it was new for us. It was important that it was new-ish. It's a place that we felt not purposely uncomfortable, but just slightly distorted, slightly at odds with ourselves, with each other, because it just gives it gives the album like the bit of friction and a bit of energy, electricity that it needed.
Okay.
But you can't generate from nothing in Ireland. The type of energy that I'm talking about comes from being around modernity, you know, being around, you know, traffic and people and neon. You Two for Girls. Wow, brilliant. I'd much rather be in a band that attracted both guys and girls, rather than be staring out at a room full of guys punching each other. Everybody is just seems much more receptive to having a positive experience. We want people to enjoy themselves when they come and see us play. And staring at a room full of people smiling and cheering and waving their arms is infinitely more appealing than staring at a bunch of guys looking glum or looking threatening.